Institut Teknologi Bandung, or ITB, was founded on March 2, 1959. Although these institutions of higher learning had their own individual characteristics and missions, they left influence on developments leading to the establishment of ITB. The institution has also freedom in deciding their measures and taking calculated risk in facing tight competition and intense pressure. In 1920, Technische Hoogeschool was established in Bandung, which for a short time in the middle 40s became Kogyo Daigaku. Not long after the Independence Day of the Republic of Indonesia in 1945, the campus housed the technical faculty. In the early 50s, a faculty of mathematics and natural sciences, also part of Universitas Indonesia, was established on the campus. In 1959, the present ITB was founded by the Indonesian government as an institution of higher learning of science, technology, and fine arts with the mission of education, research, and service to the community. I love coffee. In the period of 1960, ITB set up an agency that responsible for controlling the infrastructure development of the campus, called ITB Development Bureau. Along with the government's visions and missions, in 1970, ITB has set an academic and infrastructure master plan as an ITB's long-term strategy. The changes of the academic system of ITB was followed by the improvement of the campus facilities such as two TVST buildings. These octagonal-shaped buildings are equipped with closed-circuit TV system. ITB continually develops its infrastructure to contribute positively to the development of education and teaching system. In the northern part of Environment Engineering Department, ITB has built the twin general lecture buildings that opposite each other with the same shape and design. The multifunction hall are built in the western part of the West General Lecture Building. This building is designed to accommodate several academic and non-academic activities at maximum capacity of 2,000 people. In 1992, ITB has set a Development Master Plan, or RIP, of ITB 1992 to 2001 as the basis of 10-year development of the campus. In this period, ITB have the opportunity to build a variety of facilities in significant volume. A Japanese government financial agency called Overseas Economic Cooperation Fund has been willing to cooperate with ITB. Because of the collaboration, ITB has successfully built the Lab Tech 5, 6, 7, and 8. Lab Tech 9A, 9B, and 9C, located in the southeast area of the campus. Lab Tech 10, 11. The Widya Nusantara Plaza, North Sunken Plaza, and Sasana Budaya Ganesha District. Strong imaginary access is the advantage of the design of this infrastructure development. A grant was also used to develop the rectorate building known as the Annex Building. In this period, there is a significant change of the architecture appearance of ITB. This significant change was marked by the modern style of the building named Campus Center ITB. This building was built to meet the needs of the campus as a public space for the community. As the oldest technology-oriented university in Indonesia, ITB continually develops its infrastructure and management system to contribute positively to the development of science, technology, and art to bring the nation to the next level. To achieve these objectives, ITB has set the academic and strategic plan of ITB 2011 to 2015. more than 90 years, ITB has an active role in improving the quality of education and research in Indonesia. ITB has a vision to be the most progressive research university in Asia with focus on science, technology, and art that contributes actively in improving the nation's competitiveness.
Di sini di urat darah.